Hi, my name is Farr Satterfield. I'm the CEO of Satterfield Technologies. What we were doing before COVID-19 and what we continue to do is a focus on 3D printed knee braces, wrist braces, and elbow braces. I was invited just randomly into a Red Mountain Makers initiative to create 3D printed face shields. Based off of my experience with doing 3D printed knee braces and all, I thought, I could give that a shot. And so over the course of maybe 14 days, we went from having nothing to now we've got UAB nurses and doctors using our face masks right now. I didn't realize just how much they did not like the current masks they were using. They're uncomfortable. They also weren't designed to be reused. Well, you get something wet on them, you get, you know, any kind of different things, these things disintegrate. And there was no way of preserving them. And so one of the benefits of our mask and what we did with the 3D printing was that you can get them wet or something like that, and then you just wipe it off. It's easy to disinfect. And then if something gets on the filter, you can pop off the filter and go back to whatever it is that you're doing. So this is our prototype mask that we're doing for UAB. We integrated a silicone ring that you see not fully formed right here. We're currently working on our molds to make it a solid ring. Feedback that we got was that they wanted it to be easy to pop off the filter, so you could put in any kind of filter right here, preferably a filter that we've made, then pop it right back on. And then these straps have a buckle that allows you to shorten and lengthen them, similar to this earlier prototype I have here. So in order to put it on, just tighten that buckle, move the strap up here, tighten that buckle. And there you go, full seal. The really big things right now is making sure breathability of the filters are where it needs to be. Another reason why we transitioned from using just like off the shelf filters versus making our own is this is actually kind of hard to breathe through. It works, definitely not getting any kind of virus through it, but also not getting a lot of as much air as you would like either.
Those filters last significantly longer than the traditional mask. So that's kind of the benefit. You use less material in the filter, which is the demand. We're using like almost half, a little bit less of the surface area for the filter. And that's not touching your face. So the oils, the movement of your face isn't going to compromise the structural integrity of it. So now the filter lasts longer, which is also part of the solution. I'm helping Forrest connect dots as far as kind of the business end of things, meeting some people that, you know, can fund this project or, you know, make orders to hospitals. We've talked to UAB, other nurses and doctors at St. Vincent. After we fulfill medical orders, we would love to, you know, help get these masks to factories or stores so that they can, you know, resume work.
We've got some people up in Huntsville Hospital using them, people at UAB. We're talking with the fire department here at the city of Birmingham. We're talking with just the city of Birmingham in general, because they need like policemen, garbage collectors, and everybody else in between to be protected because they're interacting with the public. You've got a deficit in personal protective equipment that is resulting in greater infection rates, that is resulting in a lot of fear and anxiety. It is our duty, our responsibility to do everything that we can to help these people in this moment. You know, it's not a matter of making money or anything like that. It's a matter of what can we do now to help prevent people from dying.
What I want to happen with these face masks is kind of our Marines with the M16s, our frontline, our hospital workers having the protection they need. That's what I want to have happen, is everybody that works a hospital to be able to have a lasting form of protection. That's why I'm involved, is it's something I could help somebody I know that's super talented. He can make an incredible product, I know that, and I can help get it to the right people. So I'm just a little cog in this, and that's the most exciting part about it.